for the sign of Sagittarius. Hello and welcome to my channel. Just remember the bottom cards are paired with the top cards. I'll be going through the past, present, challenge, and outcome. So in the recent past, we have the Page of Pentacles. Now with the Page of Pentacles, it can be a card about boredom in some ways. Now, you could have been tempted to say or do things to shake things and people up in the past just for a little excitement. What you needed to do or what you did was rethink that impulse and find a better use of your energy. Now, excitement, it can be created, and you knew that. So, with the Page of Pentacles, it's an excellent energy to support you when you have tedious work to get accomplished. It can also give you focus, backbone, and the will to stick with a task that is not necessarily glamorous or fun. And we have this card paired with the Emperor. Now, with the Emperor, it shows us in the picture that domination over the mind, over the heart, is sometimes necessary, even though it's not wanted. Now, in fact, it should be welcomed, and that is what you must think when this card appears in a reading. So, when hard choices need to be made, it's important to maintain your concentration and focus. And this would have been in the past. Now, the Emperor signals this, it signals this, but he also signals that now is definitely a time you should find it easier to make hard choices. So go ahead and enjoy the assertiveness and the confidence that this self-controlled and focus brings, or that it would have brought you in the past. You forged ahead and you did what you know is best, or you did what you thought was best in the past. So if you could have mastered yourself, then you should have had little problem mastering most of the other obstacles that life threw at you at that time. And once again, that was the past. Now we move on to the present. We have the Two of Cups. Now the Two of Cups, it often refers to romantic partnerships, as you can see in the picture. But you have to keep in mind that that's not its only connotation. Now, it can speak of balance, friendships, joy, and sharing. So, basically, this is a card that says things are more than likely to be going very well for you now. You should be feeling more than usually loved, cared for, and content. And we have this card paired with the Magician. Now, this card, it signifies new beginnings and great expectations. It reminds us that we have the power to make a difference in our lives and in the world if we simply make a point to try to do that. So this is actual transformation of the literal and figurative world in normal ways. So you're not going to have it all handed to you on a plate, but if you have the potential to have that plate and a lot of what's on that plate if you do the magic yourself. So you can have what's on the plate, but you have to do the magic yourself, because the magician is all about action. If you do nothing, you'll get nothing. If you don't know what to do, it's best to just try to do something, because anything is better than nothing. In other words, if you don't try, you won't get. And with these two cards paired together, the Two of Cups is saying it's an overall great time for romantic partnerships, friendships, joy, sharing and caring, and feeling content. And it's paired with the Magician card. Now, you'll need to do something. You need to take action to sustain the Two of Cups, to keep the Two of Cups alive. So take action, do something while you're experiencing great romantic partnerships and love and joy. So don't just sit around and feel the great experience that comes with the Two of Cups. You should be doing other things, taking action, and doing something other than just sitting back and relaxing. So that's going to be the best thing. That's going to be the best thing to do while you experience the joy that comes with the Two of Cups. And that's in the present. Now we move on to the challenge. We have the Nine of Pentacles. Now, this is one of the most uplifting and encouraging cards in the tarot. This can mean that your financial worries are over for quite some time, and that things overall will be going better than you thought possible. So enjoy this good energy and share your wealth and happiness with others. And we have this card paired with the Queen of Pentacles, which indicates that you will be spending time, money, and energy on your home. It relates to home or your home surroundings. You'll be trying to get it to be more comfortable and more suitable for you. So this is a good thing now, provided you don't take on too much expenses and debt. Also, people will be looking to you for insight and or advice. You will be able to help them if you are inclined to do so. Now, this is a time period where you can get a whole lot accomplished. So with these two cards paired together, the Nine of Pentacles is an uplifting and encouraging time, and your finances should be going very well for you now, and you'll probably want to spend some time around the house fixing it up and getting a lot of things accomplished would be good for you right now. And that's with the Queen of Pentacles paired with the Nine of Pentacles. And that's going to be your challenge. Okay? And it's basically saying that to be careful about spending too much money, but you'll be making more money than you expected at this time. But try not to spend it all. And so from the challenge, we're going to move on to the outcome. And we have the Six of Cups. Now, this card is often about nostalgia, as you can clearly see. You could be looking back on how things used to be. It can be, but not always, connected with childhood or children. It's going to be important not to spend too much time and effort thinking about the good old days. Now, we have happy memories to reflect on from time to time. But if we start thinking that the best of all the years have gone by, then that can become a self-fulfilling prophecy. And we have this card paired with the Chariot, which indicates a lot of energy, but it's not a free-for-all energy. It's directed, controlled, and has a goal. It has a goal in mind. Now, when this card appears, you're more than likely to be fairly clear on what your hopes and dreams involve and what you are willing to do to make them come true. Now, overall, this card, it points to determination and ambition. It's about getting things done and testing and proving that you've got what it takes. Now, this is a sign that you should move forward. You should move forward with whatever you have in mind and your heart and give it your best shot. Remember that you'll need to use both your intellect and your heart in order to truly be satisfied. And with these two cards paired together, the Six of Cups, it's about childhood. You could be looking back on your childhood, or you could be focused on the children that you have. And it's important to not spend too much time on that and thinking about the good old days. It's okay to reflect from time to time, but don't start thinking that the best of all the years have gone by, because like the pictures show, it can be a self-fulfilling prophecy, and it's paired with the Chariot card. And the Chariot card is about determination and ambition. So don't hold yourself back by thinking about the past or the childhood memories, because the Chariot, you can get a lot of things accomplished, because at this time you'll have a lot of determination and ambition, and you're gonna need to use both your intellect and your heart in order to truly be satisfied with the outcome. And that is actually the outcome. So, Sagittarius, I hope this resonates. As you know, general readings, they do not always resonate with everyone. Then again, if you like this reading, please like, subscribe, leave a comment if that's what you'd like to do. I thank you so very much for watching, and have a great day.